Welcome to my channel. How's everybody doing today? I'm doing okay, I guess. Today we're just going to do something simple and quick and easy. So I'm going to do two color blooms. First, my colors are going to be this green that I made up. It's a custom color that I made. It's got some silver and some, I think I used the Vivid Intense green. I'm not positive. And then I've got this Prism Pour Black Raspberry. It's a beautiful color. I'm not going to use these two colors together, but my other color that I'm going to use with both of them is going to be this custom gray I made. Silver, actually. It's silver, and then I put some sparkles in it with some dragonfly gray glaze. I always say graze. I don't know why. It just comes out that way. But anyways, so this is super sparkly too. And let's get started. We're going to use some Tricorn Black Sherwin-Williams, because it's my favorite right now. Let's see, let me get a little more. It's my favorite. It's the most messy, but that's probably why it's my favorite. And it's just a little itty bitty tiny canvas. So cute. Just bring this all the way to the edge. That way we don't have a problem going over. Okay. There we go. Alright. We're going to start with the green color. This is really pretty. Okay, first we'll do the green and silver. Silver on there, so let's put a little more green on the top. All right, black cell activator today, Aussie Floetrol, and what did I use? Amsterdam. Oh shoot, what did I use, guys? Sorry. Should have known. Oh, Liquitex Basics Black. So, yeah. Not sure which one, but anyway, let's just do it. Probably should have used white, because using a black cell activator with a black base is kind of hard to see when you blow through, but mini blower. Yeah. All right, we'll let that come back a little bit. Shake it around, help it out. Oh, it's pretty, sparkly. And you know, we got to do some mods. Can you guys see it? Can't tilt it too much because it'll be all off the canvas. Yeah, that'll work. It's pretty much all gonna spin off anyway, so I'm not gonna bother to do some mods right now because it's gonna spin off anyway. This canvas is so little, it's too close to the edge, so you know it's gonna spin right off. All right, so let's just give her a little twirly whirl, huh? Oh, I probably should center that a little bit better. Actually, let me come to this side a little, because come that way a little bit.
I need your arms around me. I need to feel your touch.
We still have a lot of paint, but we'll see. Check it. And the way to check it is lift it up, tilt it. If you see your paint moving, you probably have too much on there. See how it's not moving a lot, but it is moving. So I'm gonna walk it down this way just a little bit, and then we'll spin again. Yeah, for sure. Okay, and we're good. Not really sure what you're seeing. I hope you can see it good. Came out beautiful. I love the colors. All right, yay! Okay, now give me 1 second and we'll get ready for the next one. Okay, we're back, and now we have this weird little triangle shape, huh? And we're going to use the Black Raspberry Prism Pour color this time. And I'm not sure if I want to do a bloom vine or just a regular bloom. I've never really done a bloom vine, so let's just try it. Why not, huh? Guess I probably should have watched somebody do it before I tried it, but we're gonna try it anyway. Oops, we don't want the green, we want the silver. Just get it all in there. Maybe a little more of this color. Yeah, I'm not really sure. I'm probably doing it all wrong, but we're doing it anyway, so let's just go with it. Baby blower. Looks like a mess, don't it? A That's my version of a bloom vine, people. Oh, goodness. Okay. Yeah. Uh-oh, something's dragging. Look. Oh, there it is. Oh, big old goober. Okay. Got some little swirlies and, as Wombat would say, wispy bits. This one's for you, brother. Okay, now, it's pretty colors. It's really dark. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Just wipe the bottoms. It doesn't keep pulling. I like to use my finger because I can feel the drips under there and get a nice smooth under part. Instead of missing drips and stuff like I do with my palette knife. So I like to use my finger. That way I can feel the whole bottom of the canvas and you can get it nice and like it just turns out better. See? Okay. There it is. I don't know if you can see it very good, but I will bring you down for a close-up. And sorry it was so simple this week, guys. I've had a really long, rough week. Trip to California just wore me out, so I figured I'll just keep it simple and pretty. And I think I got it. What do y'all think? Let me know in the comments. Like and subscribe if you like what you see. I could use the subscribers. That helps me out a lot. And thank you so much for watching. Yeah. Hold on for the close-up. Okay, here's the first one. Get you a little sparkly close-up going. Look at that sparkle. So pretty. Okay, there's one. And this was the second one. Equally as sparkly. Even where the black is, it came out sparkly. All right. Thanks for joining me, you guys. You're so awesome. Oh, quick update on the piggy polish. If you saw my piggy polish video, they do separate. Just know that they separate. I put two BBs in there so that when I shake it, it will unseparate. But yes, it does separate. Oops, sorry. But you can get it to come right back. You just have to shake it. But you have to put the BBs in there. See, I just shook it a little bit, but it'll take some shaking and it'll come right back. There we go. You know, obviously I didn't shake it enough, but two BBs. I stole them out of my BB gun. But you can see one of the BBs there. You just have to knock it loose so that they'll just start mixing it up. Hell, you could put as many as you want in there. But anyways, okay, thanks again for watching, guys. See you next time. Bye-bye.